Welcome to Wednesday Night Worship. Welcome those who are here on campus and taking care of all of our technical stuff. Thank you for an awesome praise team tonight. Welcome to those who will be tuning in and those who've already joined us. We're glad you're with us. Let's ask God's blessing as we share all these opportunities to worship, to fellowship, and encourage one another. Lord, we come to you tonight and say thank you for the gift of this day. Thank you for this opportunity tonight to worship together. Lord, we pray for those who are serving in the disaster relief areas that you might minister through them. Lord, we ask your blessing tonight as we encourage one another from your word. So we say thanks for all these things in Jesus' name. Amen and amen. All right, tonight, you know, when we face being overwhelmed with all the trouble and the difficulty, and we're stressed out, one of the greatest encouragements the Bible gives to us is go back to the basics. And so we're going to look at the Apostle Paul as he encourages a church, the early church, of how they were struggling, persecution and trouble, and yet he said, go back to the basics. And so we'll look at what that is tonight. So enjoy the music, sing along, and I'll be back in a few minutes to share God's word.
All right, this is a song we've been learning as a congregation. It's a great song. We invite you to sing words will be on the screen, The Goodness of God.
Mommy.
for tuning in tonight. If you have a copy of God's Word, I'd encourage you to find Galatians chapter 6. It's way over in the New Testament. Galatians chapter 6. And if you'll find verse number 7, while you're looking, turning there, when we think about the basics, when you're overwhelmed, when you're struggling, it's good to stop, take a deep breath, and then go back to the basics. Go back to what you know, what you're confident in. And that's what the Apostle Paul encouraged the early church. They were suffering perhaps very difficult persecution, having lots of stress and trouble in their little family church. And so with that, Paul writes this great letter, and we'll read just a couple verses as he kind of sums it up to help them focus, endure the fatigue that all the trouble brings and the stress, and with that encourages them to be faithful. So let's look at what he writes and ask God to apply it to our life tonight as well. Don't be deceived, for God is not mocked. For whatever man sows, he will also reap. Because the one who sows to his flesh will reap corruption from the flesh, but the one who sows to the Spirit will reap eternal life from the Spirit. So, we must not get tired of doing good, for we will reap at the proper time if we don't give up. Therefore, as we have opportunity, we must work for the good of all, but especially for those who belong to the household of faith. When you're overwhelmed, you're struggling, being pulled perhaps in every direction, it's good to stop and go back to what you know and focus on what God really wants to do in your life. Now, we could ask the question at this point, as many will, and that time is coming for all of us, usually brought on by stress and crisis in our life, and we ask ourselves the question, is it really worth it to do whatever God has called you to do? And you begin to question or struggle with where God has planted you, what he's asked you to do. All these kind of things come into focus. And yet the Apostle Paul encourages the early Christians at the church at Galatia. He tries to get them to refocus. Focus on remembering that nothing is wasted with the Lord. If you sow good things, spiritual things, then we can expect to reap good things, spiritual things. But if we strictly look out for what we want, and he refers to that as the flesh, because we have to struggle in our life between the spirit and the flesh, because our flesh has many desires. We get hungry, we have needs, and things call out to us. And so he encouraged them to refocus and see that giving your life, giving your time, your talent, your resources to spiritual things, you can reap a great reward, not just here, but for eternity. And so the first thing Apostle Paul encourages them in the midst of their persecution and struggle is to refocus. Remember that nothing's wasted with the Lord. And then the second thing is, he said, you know, you get fatigued, you get tired, you get weary, and you wonder at that point, is what I'm doing, is it doing any good? Is it making a difference? And Paul reminds them in this, he said, don't give up. Keep going, because at the proper time, we will see fruit. We will see a reward. We will reap what we sow and even more. And so he encourages them there in verse 9 that, you know, hang in there. Perhaps you need to step back and take a few moments to get recharged. And when you refocus, all right, God the Holy Spirit will be there to help all of us that spiritual energy to continue to serve, knowing that it's not wasted for the Lord. And then finally, he talks about, where do we start? What do we want? We don't want to neglect our home, our family. That's the hardest mission field. I say it over and over again, but it's the one most worth it. And so make sure that you give your best, because when we all arrive in heaven, all the things that we've accumulated on earth won't matter. But what will matter is our family, our friends, our loved ones who are in heaven with us. And so Paul begins and wraps up this wonderful letter to encourage those who were struggling to refocus. Don't quit. And with that, look forward to what God is going to do. And don't neglect the most important mission field, and that is, I believe, our family. And then with that, when we're ministering, giving our best to minister to our family, then God gives us other opportunities to share and to minister. Now tonight I want to highlight four things that we as a church have committed through all this COVID. And it's not been easy, and it's been hard. There have been times when we've been fatigued, but just to refocus tonight and to realize that nothing is wasted for the Lord. And the first thing is, we have committed to make worship a very important part of our Christian life and our Christian ministry here at the church. Now, it's not been easy to worship. We've had to be flexible. We've had to go online, and I'm grateful for those who are serving us even tonight to make this technology work. And I'll say it over and over again, technology is great when it works. When it doesn't work, it's very stressful. And I'm so grateful that you've tuned in and that those are here tonight. And thank you for your prayers and encouragement and your feedback. It helps us continue to get better at ministering and worshiping God. Now with that, let me encourage you in your own private time and with your family is to make worship the priority of your home life. And begin by praising God and thanking Him, and let it be a joyful time in your home and in your family of praising Him. And that's where we experience not only His presence, but His power. And so worship is very powerful when we honor the Lord and we receive that encouragement, that uplift with the songs and the study and all those things. And so let your home be an awesome place of praising God and worshiping with your family. Now, what if you're a single person? You still can do it. Get some good wonderful music, get your Bible open, spend some time praising God. The Bible's full of examples of people who were by themselves and they experienced the presence and power of God. And so Jesus does promise where two or three are gathered together, Jesus promises His presence and His encouragement. But whether we're alone or in a group, make worship the most important, powerful thing in your life. And out of that worship can flow the other things that God asks us to do. Now, with that, we've also committed as a church to minister to a people group, and God's given us a great privilege to minister to our deaf friends. And I'm grateful for our interpreters. Miss Linda here is interpreting tonight. Give yourself a pat on the back. And all the other interpreters who'll be up here later. But, you know, it's a people group that we all have problems, but it seems like this people group, our deaf friends, had added stress. And their problems are compounded often because of the struggle with their hearing and some other needs in their life. And so God has privileged us as a church. We've continued to try to serve and reach out to this people group who have often very little access to the gospel. But I'm grateful for the technology and the opportunity God's given to us. And so would you join us as a church in praying for this people group, that God would continue to help us as a church to be faithful, to encourage and minister. I know that this group have experienced some great loss in the last few weeks. Several members of this people group have passed, and I know that many of our deaf friends are grieving. And so join me in adding the deaf ministry to your prayer list. Thank you for being a part of what God is doing in a great way. And what a joy it is to see how God is working among the deaf. Another commitment we've made as a church during this time is to continue investing in the future. God has blessed us in our people, our place of ministry here, to invest in a ministry that's been going strong for many years, our child care ministry. Tonight, I just want to highlight and just praise the Lord, because these are people who are gifted to serve. God has provided us the resources, and opening up during the COVID time and beginning to reach out to those who are essential workers, and then further from there. What a blessing it's been for us to minister and encourage this group of families and to see their children as we invest. You know, when you pray for and work with children and youth, you're investing in the future. We have a wonderful opportunity to influence them for good. And what a joy it is to see how God works in their life. And the benefit of long-term ministry is to see them when they're small and see them grow up. And what a blessing to see so many who are out serving the Lord. And so would you continue to pray for our church as we minister to our neighborhood, our community, through our child care ministry, and pray for our workers, that God would give them wisdom as they continue to, because I know I'm experiencing it way out of my comfort zone of using this technology. And we've had to upgrade and expand our technology to minister to these kids. And so thank you for your prayers and support and your encouragement. Another area we've committed as a church is to support disaster relief. We're blessed to have those who have gone for the training, those who've gone out to serve, and right now, we have one of our members who's serving in Louisiana. Is there a good sign for Louisiana? Make up a sign for Louisiana. You know, they've experienced a lot of damage, and it's a long ways away. And yet, our disaster relief here from Michigan has been called out. The second group is there working. And one of our members is there representing the Lord, serving on the team, and representing our church. And so we want to pray for those who serve in disaster relief. And there's more training opportunities coming up in October. And so would you pray about taking the training? There's lots of opportunity with the chainsaw unit, the feeding unit, and lots of other ways to serve. And so what a blessing it is for our church and our state to have these volunteers who've been trained and who are willing to go out and to serve, because they do two important things. One is they provide support in the midst of crisis. A couple weeks ago, I talked about how difficult it is to minister to people who've lost everything. And disaster relief gives opportunity to be with people who've suffered great loss. And with that, they bring spiritual comfort with prayer and support, helping them clean up and to deal with the loss in their lives. And so I'm grateful for our church and the partnership that we share. Tonight, these are just some of the ministries that we've tried to maintain and continue during this time of COVID. And it's not been easy, but thank you for your prayers. Thank you for your support and giving. And thank you most of all for those who are able to serve and to make us aware of how God is working. And so tonight, let's apply what Paul encouraged the early church, who perhaps was undergoing severe persecution, is to step back, refocus in the midst of the trouble, and with that, go back to the basics, go back to what we know. And what we know is that the Lord's with us. He's not overwhelmed and shocked or surprised by all this trouble, but he promises to never leave us or forsake us, and he's with us in the trouble. And so with that, focus on what does the Lord desire of us as individuals, as families, as a church. And then when you get weary, you get tired, and the devil would say, why don't you just quit? That's when we can call upon the Lord and receive that spiritual strength and continue to work and be faithful. And that's what we want to do as a church. Sadly, I have to report that many, many churches have suffered great loss, and many have closed, probably not to reopen. And so I'm so grateful the Lord's been with us. The faithful prayers and giving of the people of this church that have kept us going. And we're working on the fall plan of when we can come back into the building and open up some of our other ministries. I'm grateful for those who've used technology like Zoom continue to have small groups and Bible study, and just grateful for everyone who, instead of throwing up your hands and saying, I'm done, I quit, rather, what can we do? Lord, show us what we continue to do as we prepare for this fall. Thank you for watching tonight. I want to pray for us. First, a prayer of thanksgiving for those who prayed for us, those who've stood with us, those who have given, those who have served. Thank you so much for bringing us through this so difficult time. And then I want to pray that God would give us wisdom as a church, as families, as individuals, of how we can prepare for this fall and look forward to what great things God's going to do. So let's stop here and pray and ask the Lord to help us. Dear Lord, thank you as we study your word tonight, that you use the great apostle Paul to help a church that was struggling, perhaps in great persecution. Lord, thank you for the encouragement that he was able to give to them. And Lord, tonight I'm grateful, I'm thankful for all those who have prayed for us in our church, those who've given the resources to maintain our ministries, those, Lord, who've been able to serve. Thank you for your blessings. Thank you that you brought us through this most difficult time. And then, Lord, I pray that you give us wisdom as leaders, as a church, how to prepare for the fall of what you would desire of us. Lord, I pray that we continue to be a positive influence in our community. Lord, that we would be a blessing to our homes and our families. And that, Lord, we're grateful for those who are still out serving around the world. We just ask your blessing tonight on them. For all these things, Lord, I pray in Jesus' name. Amen. We have a song that gives us opportunity to reflect on what the Lord has spoken to all of us tonight. Would you use this song to encourage and inspire you? And perhaps God is speaking to you of how to respond And I'll be back at the end of the song and with some final words. But let God use this song to minister to you during this time.
I invite you to sing with us, Mighty to Save. Words will be on your screen. Love to have an opportunity to hear and to pray with you. Always appreciate the comments and feedback on Facebook. Please call us. You'll see the contact information up there. And let's encourage one another, support one another as God continues to help us through these difficult days. The Lord bless you for being with us tonight. Our next time together is Sunday morning. Tune in at about 11 o'clock and we'll worship together. We've got a couple more weeks where we'll be outside on the lawn under the tents. And so if you would like to come out and have a live worship outside, we'll enjoy that time together. So God bless you. Thank you for being with us tonight. Hang on for another minute. Enjoy the music. We'll leave the contact information up there and love to hear how God is working in your life. God bless you.